Campaign 2018 is sponsored by Wisconsin Hospital Association, Wisconsin Counties Association, Wisconsin Realtors Association, Marshfield Clinic Health System, and Campaign 2018 partner Milwaukee Journal Sentinel.
WisconsinEye covering the elections at the Milwaukee Public Library. Democratic Representative Fred Kessler of Milwaukee is seeking re-election in the 12th District. Fred, welcome back to WisconsinEye.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
Only 8 days ago, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled, punted is the term, on the major redistricting case. I've got a lot of issues to talk about, so give us the overview of the response, and do you think you're ultimately going to prevail?
I believe we will ultimately prevail. What I think happened is that once the Beneschick case came down, which was filed and accepted in the Supreme Court, that changed the dimension a little bit. And I think we were a little bit concerned that once Beneschick was even taken by the Supreme Court, we were concerned that we maybe needed to increase the number of plaintiffs who were injured by virtue of the redistricting. And so what of our original eight plaintiffs, only four were injured, were in Republican districts that could have been changed to Democratic districts. And the Chief Justice made a big deal of Bill Whitford's
standing.
Yes, this was the standing issue. You needed to have somebody who was injured, and that was the effect of that.
So you still think you're going to win. How long is it going to take?
I think we will get a decision probably within the next 6 months from the three-judge panel in Madison.
Okay.
But then we expect that the Supreme Court will probably take it up again, or certainly the Republicans will appeal again.
Okay. Now, you and I are wonks. We could talk this forever, but let's talk about specific issues in you're seeking re-election. You have a primary. Number one issue in your district.
The number one issue in my district?
Yeah.
What people talk about?
Yeah.
Probably education is one of the major issues. But believe it or not, because of the fact that I send out a lot of newsletters, redistricting is talked about as I go door to door. People know because I send out a lot of newsletters and I emphasize what I have been doing. And juvenile justice is another issue, and some of the criminal justice issues are also very important.
Well, talk about schools. Now, MPS, the four-year graduation rate is 60%. Nobody's proud of that. Everybody wants to improve that. What's your thoughts on K-12 and MPS changes?
Well, you have to understand that I participated in the creation of probably three of the best schools that MPS has. And as a result of that, a fourth school was one of the best schools. 40 years ago, I and Leon Todd, who was on the school board, came up with the idea of the immersion schools. And so the immersion schools, I think, are among the best schools in the nation. And we have the only public German immersion school. And even in the French immersion school, 2 weeks ago, Leon Todd and I and one of the persons in the administration were honored for starting that school. Those are great schools, and we have a number of really great schools. But we end up having a situation where there's enormous numbers of people in poverty, and they can't because they have to work. They have to work on low-paying jobs. They can't watch their kids and make sure that the kids do the homework and create the incentives that would have to take place to make those kids focus as nicely as others do.
You're a veteran of the Choice Wars. It expanded from Milwaukee to Racine statewide. Its future, should it be allowed to continue as is? Should it be dialed back? You've watched this Choice Wars for decades.
Well, the first thing that I think I did was I was the only person to successfully offered any change to the choice bills in 209. And I got the Assembly Democratic Caucus to not take money away from MPS to fund the choice schools. Unfortunately, that was never dealt with in the conference committee. It was passed in the Assembly version of the budget, but it was never dealt with in the conference committee, and the choice continued. I think we still have to defund, but we have to have a separate track for the voucher schools. I think that they are taking too much away from Milwaukee. The effort to place special needs kids into choice schools took enormous amount of money away from Milwaukee, and they get more money than even the MPS does for treating special needs kids. And so I think, yes, they have to be reduced. I don't think right now we can eliminate them. But ultimately, I would like to see support increased for the public schools, and I want to make sure that there are quality public schools like the German, French, and the Spanish immersion, the Milwaukee School of Languages, Goldemeyer, Rufus King, Reagan, and a number of the high schools.
You're a former judge in the county.
Yes.
What can be done about Wisconsin having the highest incarceration rate of African Americans?
Well, the one thing that I tried to do all the last couple of sessions was stop efforts to increase misdemeanor penalties to felony penalties. And some of the things that were done were absolutely ridiculous. Upskirting was made a felony. That was a juvenile act, and we ended up graffiti was becoming a felony, even though no one was ever convicted of graffiti and got the maximum term. Mm-hmm. They were mostly ordered to clean it up. And what we've done is we've increased a number of these penalties, and I consistently have opposed increasing misdemeanor penalties to felony penalties. But I also think this: we need to have a parole board again, and we need to have a situation where we can grant forgiveness. And I think the other thing that has to happen is we have to have a more efficient review of probation holds, because there's a lot of people temporarily losing their jobs because they failed to make an appointment, or they missed some requirement that was minimal, and they ended up back in prison. I think we have to end up situating and making the court system more efficient so that probation holds can be reviewed by the actual sentencing judge.
Is it time to legalize recreational and medical marijuana?
I think so.
You do. Then we do not need a new state prison, is what I'm taking away from your answer to the other question.
I would think it would be terrible.
Okay. You've been a part of the debate over how, for years, how do we pay for highways and bridges? Going forward, how would you wave your wand and pay for it?
Well, I think you have to increase taxes.
Okay.
And I think you have to increase taxes on higher income people. I'm not sure, you know, I certainly would say that I would prefer to have a license or a car license fee escalated based on the value of the car, rather than have a general sales tax.
The buzz in the Capitol over tolling?
I don't think tolling would ever work.
Okay. Local governments have been dealing with levy limits since 2006. Is it time to loosen them or get rid of them?
I certainly think it should be loosened, and it's been a serious problem on school aid, on school financing.
Okay. Do we need to change gun laws in Wisconsin?
Yes, we do.
How?
48-hour waiting period. The fact is the bump stocks should be eliminated. We have to have a period of examination of the record check before people can purchase guns. And the other thing that I think, and this is the very difficult thing, is redefining assault rifles. Part of the problem is that every time we make a minor adjustment, the manufacturers change the model so that it was not covered by that adjustment. So I think we have to base it on, say, military purchases or things like that.
You voted against the Foxconn package of tax breaks and tax incentives. Don't you think there is any pathway for residents of the 12th District to get jobs at a Foxconn plant?
Well, I would certainly hope that the transportation is there. But I have to say, the hypocrisy of some of the supporters of Foxconn who claim that they're free traders, that they're free market people, and instead they want to subsidize corporations, and then at the same time want to make work requirements for food stamps. This is so totally inconsistent that I think it's hypocrisy.
I'll talk about healthcare. Two questions. Does state government have a role in retaining and recruiting physicians, nurses, and other healthcare professionals?
If you remember, I started a committee in 2009, and none of the bills that we were working on ever were even completed once the Republicans took control. I wanted to have a second or third medical school. That actually happened because the Medical College of Wisconsin did start two-year medical schools in northern Wisconsin. That was one of the major goals. But we need nursing schools, and we need to retain people who are PhD nurses because we don't have the teachers who can teach. So I think that's very important. It's one of the serious job deficiencies where I think there's great opportunities for people to go into healthcare, and I think the state needs to be much more supportive on nursing and medical school assistance.
What are your thoughts on the unique issues in rural healthcare? Older demographic, young kids leaving after high school, lower household income than the state average. Thoughts on healthcare in the rural areas?
One of the other problems that you even forgot to mention is there are a number of females who are become doctors, and they're unmarried, and they can't find husbands out in rural areas who are educationally equivalent. Mm-hmm. And so that discourages people to come out into practice in rural areas. But I think it's very important that we have still the one-on-one relationship between the doctor and patient. I don't like the substitution of a television interview or a video conference because you can't really assess a patient effectively, I think, in that way. I mean, it's better than nothing, but it's not the ideal.
Two final questions. We're in the sixth year of a freeze in resident undergraduate UW tuition. Should the freeze continue to a seventh and eighth year?
I would say this. I don't like to increase tuition, but we need to increase the appropriation for the universities. Remember when I went, the tuition was dirt cheap. And as what you went to, the tuitions were all over with dirt cheap. I don't want to burden kids with the increased debt. I think that the state has an obligation to provide quality higher education, and we missed the boat on that.
Okay, final question. You face a primary challenge August 14th. You want to talk about differences between you and your opponent in the primary?
Well, I mean, it's hard for me to understand why she's challenging me, but I am very proud of what I've been doing, and I'm the voting rights expert in the legislature, I think, and certainly among the Democrats, because I fear what's happening on the voting rights. And that's one of the things that I want to make sure that there are no additional barriers that particularly keep minority people from participating. And we are seeing what happened in Abbott versus Perez this past Monday. We are seeing what the impact of the lack of redistricting has, or the lack of fair redistricting had in Wisconsin. We are seeing the efforts to close down early voting, to have limits on where people can vote outside of City Hall. We saw last year in Alabama and Arizona how people closed polling places in minority areas. I mean, I'm fearful that the Republicans are going to try to do that because I think that's one of Trump's messages, is to restrict the voting rights. And that's certainly one the impact of the discouraging of immigration.
Thank you. Democratic Representative Fred Kessler of Milwaukee is seeking re-election in the 12th Assembly District. The primary is August 14th. Fred, thanks for talking to Wisconsin Eye.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you.